This Portland Harbour structures are built in the ocean where we have the environmental influence. The parameters that are to be considered are listed here. They are tide, surge, tsunami and wave. So, unless you know the physics as well as engineering behind this, it will be very difficult to design these structures. As you see here in this slide, the tidal range in Chennai, the mean spring tide range is 1 meter and the mean neap tide range is 0.4 meter. Basically, we have two tidal ranges, one is the spring tide, another is the neap tide. As you go towards the north, the tide range increases. On the east coast, it is around 5 meters, whereas in Kandla, where there is a creek, it goes up to 7 meters. That means in low water level, the tide will be at the entrance of ICSR building, then in high tide level, it will come to second floor level. The distance, if you see, it will be as far back as up to Kaveri Hostel also. Water will be at Kaveri Hostel during low tide, whereas in high tide, it will come to ICSR building. So, there will be a distance as well as the elevation. There are basically two tides, one is a spring tide, another is a neap tide. This period is about 12 hours, each tidal range is approximately about 12 hours and this tidal range, this is called as the neap tide and this is called as the spring tide. This is because of the sun, moon and earth attraction, this tidal ranges take place. This is a continuous process and normally what we call this initial level, this is called as the MSL and we put a chart datum which is below the lowest water level, right. CD is the chart datum which is kept below the lowest water level. We will be talking about mean of the spring tides. So, the spring tides are during new moon and full moon, that means every 15 days, every month also it will change, every year also it will change. So, you take the mean of all the spring tides. Spring tide has two water levels, one is the mean high water, another is the mean, another is the low water. If you take the mean of that, this will be the mean high water, this is the mean low water. I will put this as spring, this is spring. This level is mean of high water neap, this level is mean of low water neap. So, I defined 6 levels, one is mean high water spring, another is mean high water neap, mean sea level, mean low water neap, mean low water spring. Then we have the mean sea level. This mean sea level is used as a benchmark. So, our civil engineering students, they will be studying the benchmark. Have you seen benchmark anywhere in IIT campus? Where? BSB you have seen, nowhere else you have seen? Hostels. So, if you have seen the means this benchmark in Mandakini hostel, it may be about plus 4 and it goes maybe plus 6 or so to Tharamani guest house and ocean engineering may be plus 8. The variation may be about 3 to 4 meters from ocean engineering side to Mandakini hostel. You may not notice, it is one floor difference, but that is a level. But we have to have one more level, that is high water level. So, the chart datum is below the low water level and we can put highest high water level also. What is the requirement to know the highest high water level? Engineering requirement. Why should we know how much will be the highest high water level? Structure should be above. Structure means what should be above, not the top level of the structure. bottom of the beam deck structure. We have typically two structures, one is called as the substructure, another is superstructure. Superstructure consists of deck beams and slab. The deck beam should be, bottom of the deck beam should be above the highest high water level. Why should we know the chart datum which is below the lowest low water level? Not for foundation. Why should we know the chart datum, lowest water level? Because when the ship is coming, when the water level is going down, the ship also will go down. It should not go and touch the seabed. Suppose you want 10 meter draft, 10 meter draft should be with reference to CD. Otherwise, high water the ship will not touch the bottom, low water it will go and touch the bottom and it may break and it will cause lot of damage also. That is why we need. Okay, the surge means whenever there is a cyclone which is crossing, cyclones normally cross from the sea to the land. When it is crossing from sea to the land, it takes some amount of water, it pushes water into the land, the water level rises. It is a one time occurrence, in 4 or 5 hours it will take place, then it will recede. It is not periodic. Periodic means it is not a 12 hour cycle and all. Whenever a cyclone is crossing the land, the water level rises and then it goes into the land. It takes about 4 to 5 hours depending on the intensity of the cyclone, then the water level recedes. So, your top of the structure should be above the surge. This is your surge. Then you have waves above this. This is called as the wave height. This is called as a wave period. So, your top of the superstructure should be, you have to put something, you have to put the deck height, air gap. Typically, this is about 1.5 meter. So, on top of this level, on top of this level you should give a air gap of 1.5 meter, then you should give the deck height, then you have to fix the top of the deck level, right? Otherwise it will be a problem for you. Tsunami is a occurrence which takes place 400-500 years written period. It does not, you may not see another tsunami till your lifetime, but tsunamis has happened in India. I will give some details. We have Chola, Chera, Pandya, the kingdoms. The Chola kingdom, what was the capital? Vijayanagara. Yeah, you are going to Karnataka. Where is Vijayanagara? Chola is in Tamil Nadu. What was the capital of Chola kingdom? Before Tanjore. Mahabalipuram is for Pallavas. Pumbugar. Pumbugar was the capital. Pumbugar is between Mayiladuthurai and Chidambaram. The Chola kingdom was there in Pumbugar, and that whole city went into the sea in one of the tsunami. So now you know the importance of this, why we need to get all these things. If you take Kandla, the top level of the structure is plus 9. With reference to the chart datum, the top level is at plus 9. If you take Chennai, it is at plus 5. The cost of the structure also goes up. For the same draft, suppose draft is 10 meter, you give under clearance of plus 1 meter, then minus 11 is the bed level, top level is plus 9, that means the total height above the bed level is 20 meter in Kandla, whereas the same thing is in 16 meter. Cost is proportional to the cube of the height, because the bending moment is to the cube, it is not linear relationship. The storm surge in Orissa state is 10.2 meter above mean sea level. Anybody from Orissa state here? Nobody. This Orissa state they have what is known as a saline embankment. The saline embankment is built to protect the seawater inundation into the land. This level is at plus 10.2 meter, very close to the West Bengal border. But generally, it ranges between 2.7 meter and 9.8 meter. Andhra Pradesh storm surge varies between 3 and 6 meter. Tamil Nadu 2.7 meter and 7 meter. Have some record in Tundi, it is 11 meter. Some people are disputing, it is not recorded and all. Tundi was one of the seaport for Madurai Kingdom, but they are saying 11 meter is not correct information. Pondicherry, it is 3 meter to 4.5 meter. See, whenever a cyclone crosses, normally when a cyclone comes, it generally it hits Nagapattinam, then it hits Kadalur, then it stays near Chennai, but generally it doesn't cross, it goes to Andhra, either Nellore or Machilipattinam it goes. There are certain reasons for that, the contour and the bathymetry and the shape of the coastline and all. This figure shows what is the mean sea level, what is the normal high tide, what is the storm tide, what is the surge. So, this 17 feet is the height, because surge height is 15 meter, which has to be placed above this, it is 17 meter. Then there is a wave, wave is breaking. They have put some columns and the building, it should not go and hit. So, you should see that the top level is not hitting the building. This figure shows the tidal range at different locations, what I have discussed in Orissa state. Somewhere here, this is about 10.2 meter. So, it depends on the bay formation, it is not at other places it is less. Somewhere here it is 10.2 meters. This is the border of Andhra, where it is about 4 meter only. As you go up, it is going higher and higher. So, we have planned one port somewhere north of that location where we have got 10.2 meter. This is called as a backwater. What you are seeing here is a backwater. And they want to fill up this area because it is a very shallow contour. They want to get about 3000 acres. 3000 acres is about 5 times our campus size. Our campus is around 600 acres. So much area is required for port development. They want to build 2 breakwaters. So here they have made certain measurements. So this is for water level measurement. One instrument is used to record the tide. You can see here. Near 0 you have a low tide, near 12 hours another low tide, near 0 another low tide, near 12 another low tide. Like that you can measure the tide. The levels are given here, it varies from 4 meter to 7 meter. So, this is the equipment which is used to measure the tide. We can also, I have not listed current. Current also is a part of the tide. When the water level goes up and down, there is a current velocity which is coming, that also is measured. They generally measure it in the navigation channel, so that to see what will be the speed of the current. There are giving 2 informations, one is the speed of the current, bottom one is the direction of the current. Both the informations are required. So, when the tide rises, the water is moving towards the coast. When the tide is going down, the water is moving away from the coast. This phase difference will be about 180 degrees. So, this is somewhere around 120 and about 300. So, the phase difference is about 180 degrees. So, this shows the speed of the current, it is 0 to 1 meter per second, about 2 knots is the speed of the current. When will be the current be maximum? So, I have drawn this figure. In this figure, this is the crest point, this is the trough, this is called as upcross, this is called as downcross. I have marked here the current varies from 0 to 1 and coming back to 0. You tell me when the current will be maximum. It will be at the trough or crest or upcross or downcross out of these 4 points. Upcross and downcross will be maximum. Current is nothing but the change of elevation with respect to time. So if you take x axis is x and y axis is the height and x axis is the time period, dy by dx will be the current. So it is rate of change. The rate of change here will be nearly 0, here also it will be 0. That is the slope of the curve. The slope of the curve is this. This will be the maximum here, this will be the minimum here. So that is why this point also is important. When you want to design a structure, we will be calculating 2 things. One is how to fix the top level of the structure. The second one is how to estimate the force acting on the structure due to current and wave. For that, the phase difference is also very important. Then we will talk about a design wave. This is an important information. What is a design wave? The period of the wave as given here is about 10 seconds. Generally the wave period can start from 3 to 18 seconds. This is the range of wave period. So every day you have the wave, every hour, every minute. So 1 minute is having 60 seconds. So you will have about 10 waves. If it is a 10 second, if it is a 6 second wave, mostly 6 second waves is more predominant. This design wave, there are 2 important information we know, you should know. One is called as the significant wave height, another is known as return period. So if you want to plot normal waves which are recorded, the waves may be of like this. It will be a random phenomena. You will have smaller waves, larger waves, height wise, period wise. So it is a statistical information. So if you get some type of waves like this, how can you represent these waves by a single parameter, wave height and wave period? This is a big classroom, you know how to grade is evaluated, some statistics is involved. Suppose we will find out the height of each individual, we want to represent the class by a single height, what height you will use? Average means what? Sum of all the heights divided by the total number. That is not used in engineering for design. It can be used for engineering. We will use significant wave height. Significant wave height is also average. Average of highest 1/3 in the class. Suppose we have 54 people, we take the tallest 18 people and take the average of the 18 people. That is called as the significant wave height. Sometimes it is called as H1/3. Mostly they will ask significant wave height in the interview. It is the average of the highest 1/3 of the record. What is the duration of the record they will take? You have to take the average. Average of how many records? ocean engineering students, average of how many records you have to take? Three hours duration. Huh? Anyone told you about this? Who has told? Nobody told. What is 21? I am hearing 21. What is 21? 21 is only for marriage. 3 hours duration they record. You take the average of 3 hours record. But you cannot take one average of 3 hours record. You have to take over a period of 1 year. Right? It is not that one average you have to take. What is this return period? What is return period? I think civil engineering also this terminology is there.
How much time the highest wave level will come back?
Statistically, I told 3 hours duration. 3 hours duration for a period of 1 year you can take. You can actually measure it. For 1 year, you can put a wave rider by and you can make the measurement of waves and take the average of all the 1 year data record, H1/3 you can get, that is 1 year return period. In that year, cyclone can come, cyclone may not come and things like that. But you can extrapolate for 10 years, 100 years, 1000 years, right. The period of occurrence of cyclones in India, it may vary coast to coast, maybe Andhra once in 2 years, Tamil Nadu once in 3 years, like that it may vary. When a cyclone comes, surge also will be there and they will have very high wave heights also. So, if you take a return period of 100 years, then the significant wave height will be much higher, not very much higher. For example, this is a class where you have people from civil, mechanical, aeronautical, ocean engineering with a population of 54. You take the significant height of this class, but our institute may have about 7000 or 8000 people. You take the average of all the 8000 people, will it be higher than this or lower than this? We cannot say. Maybe these two ladies are taller. So, if you take all survey hostel population where the ladies are shorter, your average may go down. But generally, it has to be higher. You are all in third year. Most of the boys who are joining first year may already attain that height, otherwise, there will be a problem. We cannot say. But if you take the wave record, if you take a 100 year return period wave record, it will be much higher than the 1 year return period. There are statistical methods using which we can extrapolate. Do not think that we have to take 100 year record and then build the structure. Typically, they take only 1 year record, then design. Sometimes they do not even measure the waves, still they will get the wave heights. How to get the wave heights without measuring the wave height? What is causing the waves?
Wind.
Wind data is available. Wind data is recorded from 1875 or something like that. So, you can get the wind. From the wind, you can find out what will be the wave height. Then we have what is known as the ship observed wave height. There is an atlas prepared when our department started in 78 or so. We spent some money to develop a record. This is done by NIO Goa. So, based on the ship observed wave data at each location, each grid point, there are about maybe 12 grids or 16 grids all along the Indian coast. They have given the wave heights. That is also another information which can be used. Return period can be 1 year, 100 year or 1000 year. They may use 100 year return period for survival condition of the structure, 1 year return period for the operation. This is to fix the top level. This has recently come. So, design wave height, this is more for offshore structure than for Portland Harbor structure. You take the return period of 1 year and if possible assign that value for the operation of the structure. Take it for 100 years survival, that is for estimating the forces and designing the structure. Take it for 1000 years to fix the top level, right. And this significant wave height also can be H1/3 or H1/100 or H average. The statistical information of H average, H 1 by 3 or H 1 by 10 is used. So, now it is clear it is not one single parameter, one wave height and one wave period we are using as shown in the table. What we are using is a statistical parameter depending on the significant wave height and return period. So, there is a location is also important, there is a root, trunk and head. So, this breakwater, this is called as the root, this portion from here to here is called as the trunk and this portion is called as the head. There are different locations and this is the south breakwater. Generally we mark the figure north pointing upwards. So, this is the southern direction, this is the northern direction, this is on the east coast. So, this side is the east on the sea side. So, here we have marked root 2 meter, root the wave height is less because the water depth is less. I will tell how water depth is influencing the wave height later. Period is taken 10 second, wave direction also they are giving. Similarly, for trunk as well as for the head, this is for the south breakwater, this is for the north breakwater. So, this type of information is required. Generally, they give the significant wave height with 100 year return period. If it is not mentioned in the table, generally what is given is a H 1 by 3 with 100 year wave period. Now, we will move on to tsunami. So, all of you might have studied about the tsunami. So, it is because of the earthquake, because of two fault planes, one is going down, another is going up, the wave is generated. This is called as a tsunami. This shows how the tsunami is generating and then going to different places. So, when it comes to Sri Lanka, it diffracts. So, if you see here, the diffraction means it goes and there is some diffraction wave which goes to the west coast also, that is to the Kerala border also it goes. So, some shadow zone there is less disturbance. What are you seeing in this figure? Water level has come up to the deck level. So, this is the deck, this is what is called as a fender, this is a ship. This photograph is taken in Port Blair. The water level is very close to the deck level. Normally it is not like that. The water level goes up, what happens? The ship may ride on top of it, it will go on top of this. So, it should be avoided mainly to fix the top level, but here the water has gone on top of it and it has receded. But luckily none of the ship has gone on top of this. There are various locations starting from 326 BC, 12th April 1762, 1868, Bay of Bengal, Andaman Island, Sundarbans, Sri Lanka, this Pumbuhar, all these places tsunami has taken place. The latest one is on 26 December 2004. This is one of the worst tsunami whatever I have historically shown. Based on that, this is the worst tsunami. This is with 9.3 in Richter scale, North Sumatra coast. It has affected India. And what is the input here? This shows where it has got affected, where the tsunami has hit on the southern and coastal India. This is made by our department people. There are two charts I am going to show you, one is the run up, another is the inundation. Run up means how much water level has gone up. So, here the scale is given. This is the typically the Tamil Nadu border, Tamil Nadu coast. From here to here it may be about 1 centimeter, it is about 2 meter. So, if you see here, this may be around 3 centimeter, that means it is about 6 meter of run up. Run up means how much the water level has gone up, okay. Then another important parameter is the inundation. Inundation about 1 centimeter is 500 meter, how much distance it has travelled in. So this may be around 1500 meters, 1.5 kilometers. Inundation only is creating a lot of problem for human life and property, mainly because if the shoreline is very flat, the coastal land, the topographic contour is not varying very much like Nagapattinam and all. The variation 1.5 kilometer away from the coastline and at the coastline, the level difference may not be even more than 1 meter. Water level rises by 6 meter means so much water will go in. Lot of people's life is lost when the water was receding. What happened is initially the water was receding. When they saw about 500, 600 meter on the sea where the water was there, it was going back. People went inside to see why it is going back. Then the another wave has come, tsunami wave. The period is very large for the tsunami. A period is not 10 seconds and all, it is in minutes. So when the another wave is coming, people started running. The speed of this tsunami wave, can you tell me what will be the speed of the tsunami? Numerical value, how many kilometer per hour? Who are aeronautic students here? Aeronautical, what is the speed of the plane? Not Dreamliner and all, I don't know what is this Dreamliner. What is generally the speed of the plane? Aeronautical student, let them tell. What is the speed of the plane? How many of you have travelled in aircraft? Okay, where from you have travelled? Which place to which place?
Bhuvaneshwar to Vizag.
Bhuvaneshwar to Vizag. You are from Vizag or Bhuvaneshwar?
Sir, I live in West Bengal.
So West Bengal. Bhuvaneshwar to Vizag, what is the distance?
I don't know, it takes some
15
minutes by flight.
15 minutes you cannot go. 15 minutes it won't take, it will take more, 50 minutes, about an hour. What is the distance? How many are from Andhra here? Andhra, what is the length? From the Chennai is the border, very close to Chennai is the border. Northern border is somewhere near Gopalpur. Bhuvaneshwar is another 300 kilometer or 200, it will be about 600 kilometers. Flying time is 1 hour means it will be 600 kilometer per hour. The tsunami speed is 600 kilometer per hour, very close to that. From Port Blair, when they sense the tsunami and they reported, we have about 1.5 hours, very close to 2 hours warning. The tsunami has taken 2 hours. The flight also will take roughly about 2 hours from Port Blair to Chennai. Tsunami also will take 2 hours to reach. We could have saved the life because our previous tsunami is 500 years back. So we don't know what is this and all. So future we will take care. There is about 2 hours time difference is there. Once it struck Port Blair, it will take 2 hours to come. But the 600 kilometer per hour is not at the coast. It depends on the water depth. When it comes to the coast, when it feels the sea bottom, the speed reduces, it reduces to about 40 kilometer per hour. But nobody can run 40 kilometer per hour. So that is why it is so loss. I will be discussing another lecture on tsunami where all these calculations will be given. Then we give this tsunami hazard differentiate into high, medium and low depending on the inundation level, run up height, tsunami intensity, likelihood of tsunami, damage observed in earlier tsunami, reef damage. So you can classify the different locations in Indian coast as high, medium or low. Then it means the inundation level is about 5 meters, run up height is 3 meters, tsunami intensity we give some factor 2, and then likelihood and damages. This is how we want to classify the tsunami. This is a tsunami prediction system where we measure the water level variation in very deep waters. In very deep water, the tsunami height is not much, maybe about half a meter or 1 meter only. 5000 meter water depth, the water level variation will be only half a meter or 1 meter. So it is very difficult to sense this pressure, but we need sophisticated equipment to do this. Then we will move on to the last topic, that is about the wave rose diagram. Maybe I will do it in the next class.